As interrogators start asking questions, they might be doing so without informing Tsarnaev of his right to remain silent and his right to an attorney. 11 News reporter Sarah Sampson spoke to a legal expert about the suspect's Miranda rights and what it means if they're skipped. She's live in the 11 newsroom with more on that. Sarah?
Well, Deborah, there are some exceptions that allow Miranda rights to be skipped, but even if this case doesn't fit those exceptions, the only consequence to not Mirandizing a suspect is that what he says can't be used in court. Now, our expert says if investigators don't need a statement from Tsarnaev for a conviction, that might not be a problem.
Authorities want answers from accused marathon bomber Dzhokhar Tsarnaev as he recovers in a Boston hospital. But how they will go about getting them is being debated in Washington.
This man, in my view, should be designated as a potential enemy combatant, and we should be allowed to question him for intelligence gathering purposes.
Attorney Andrew Alperstein says enemy combatant designation is one of two occasions when authorities can skip the Miranda rights. He says it grew out of 9/11.
But that has never, ever been done to a U.S. citizen. That has never happened before, and I think that the government's probably nervous about doing that because I think that it would cause some problems potentially down the road, and I know they don't want to mess this case up.
Tsarnaev became a citizen last year. The Obama administration has given the go-ahead for the other exception, a public safety waiver. But Alperstein says if it's used in this case, that would also be new territory.
It's an exception where the government and law enforcement don't need to give somebody the Miranda rights because it's such an imminent danger, such an emergency situation. The longest that any case has ever upheld that is 50 minutes. Now we're 6 days plus past this.
Tsarnaev has been in serious condition and unable to communicate, which Alperstein says could actually serve as a benefit to him legally. He believes the government will be very cautious when it comes to how they handle questioning.
The law enforcement agents have to make a decision now, and then a judge is going to decide later whether their judgment now was the appropriate judgment.
Alperstein says it all depends on the government's priorities. If they already feel they have enough evidence to convict without a statement from Tsarnaev, simply getting information might be the top priority.
And the only consequence is that the statement wouldn't be used in court. But it doesn't mean the statement can't be used to go pursue, you know, some terrorist organization or some charge some aider and abettor who helped them.
There's also still a question of where Tsarnaev will face charges. If he's charged in federal court, he could face the death penalty, something the state of Massachusetts doesn't have. Alperstein says both state and federal charges are possible. Reporting live in the newsroom, Sarah Sampson, WBAL-TV 11 News.